All right. Can we see it? All right, so again, good evening, everybody. My name is Kelsey Johnson, and I am the Concurrent Enrollment Transition Advisor with Anoka-Ramsey Community College. It is quite a long title, but basically it just means my main role is to help support students that are in our concurrent enrollment program with Columbia Heights, but with also our 14 other partner high schools with Anoka-Ramsey. So if it were a typical year, which we know it is not, I would be at Heights a couple times a month, checking in with students and being a liaison between the school or the high school and the college. And I'll talk a little bit more about my role and what I can help support students with as we get towards the end of the presentation. But just a little heads up about what we're going to cover. I'm going to go over what concurrent enrollment is, what are some benefits, some important policy things that we think you should know, and then also how do you qualify, how are you able to take these classes. So with that, we will go ahead and get started. So what is concurrent enrollment? Mr. Miller talked about this briefly, but concurrent enrollment is when students are enrolled at the high school and the post-secondary institution at the same time. So students are taking college classes and earning college credit, but they're doing it at the high school. Those classes are taught at the high school. So for Columbia Heights, that's students are taking Anoka-Ramsey classes, but at Columbia Heights High School. And so those classes will show up on your Columbia Heights transcript as well as your Anoka-Ramsey transcript. You'll be starting a permanent post-secondary college transcript as well. And how we're able to do all that is through our teachers. So classes are taught by Columbia Heights High School teachers. These teachers are credentialed, and that means that they have taken graduate level courses in their field. And so then we partner them with a faculty member on our campus. And those two are really what makes this work, because they work together to make sure the class at Columbia Heights is going to be the same as the class at Anoka-Ramsey. So concurrent enrollment in general, you're earning college level credit, you're taking college classes, but taught by your high school teachers at your high school. You don't need to leave. So there are some obvious benefits to that. I'm going to talk about a few that I think are really important. And number one is being able to stay at the high school. Again, in a more traditional year, as we know this is not, when you're taking these classes, you could stay at the high school. So you can enrich that high school experience. You can stay with your friends, stay with those teachers that you know, and you have that kind of built-in support system already that you might not have if you're going to take these classes on a college campus. Also, if you are in sports or any extracurricular activities, taking these classes during your regular school day without having to leave can definitely help make that possible to do both things. And then another benefit, college admissions. You are already demonstrating your ability to achieve in college level courses. So that's what admissions officers are going to look for. They want to see that you can be successful in rigorous coursework. Not only is it going to show up on your high school transcript that you've taken a college course, you're going to have your own college transcript to show and show that you were able to be successful in college courses already. And then getting a head start. So these classes could potentially reduce the time required to complete an associate or bachelor's level or a bachelor's degree. And I'm going to get into that in the next slide a little more. And then last but definitely not least, they're free. So these classes, you don't have to pay for the tuition, the books are free, you're not worrying about getting to and from campus, there's no transportation, they're taught at your high school during the normal school day, all for free. So on the screen are the classes that we're offering this year at Columbia Heights, and so as you can see, they're all really some core kind of general classes. You've got art, English, math, and some science, and that's really what students come to Anoka-Ramsey to do. So we're a community college. Most students come to us with the intent to leave, with the intent to transfer and earn a four-year degree somewhere else. So a majority of the classes that we offer are going to be those lower level general education courses, classes that are going to, you're going to get those done cheaper with us and then move on to a four-year institution. So everything that we are offering within that concurrent enrollment program falls into that category of lower level general education courses. So they are going to be our most transfer friendly courses, And that's why I say they could potentially help you get a head start or reducing the time needed to earn a 2-year or 4-year degree, because you can get some of those lower level generals out of the way while you're still in high school. Okay, so there are some obvious benefits, but there are some risks or things to think about if you wanna take some concurrent enrollment classes. As I said, when you take concurrent enrollment, you're enrolled at the high school and the college. So you become an Anoka-Ramsey student. And we have to hold those students to some of the same policies as our on-campus students as well. And I wanted to share just a few that we see the most with our concurrent enrollment program. And the first one is add drop. So on our campus, students can add or drop a course, move it around, change their schedule as much as they want within the first 5 days. Now, let's say on the 6th day, they decide they don't want to be in that class anymore. That's no longer a drop. That becomes a withdraw. So that becomes a W on their college transcript. That's the same for our high school students. We allow the first 5 days to add or drop that course without any repercussion. Let's say a couple weeks into college English, you decide this class is too hard, I want out of it. You can't just drop it like you maybe normally could another high school course. It does become a W or a withdraw on your permanent college transcript. And there can be some repercussions. And so that's where our academic standing comes into play. Students on our campus, as well as our concurrent enrollment students, need to meet some minimum standards. One is that they have to have a 2.0 GPA in all of their Anoka-Ramsey classes, so a C average. The other is they need to complete 67% of the Anoka-Ramsey classes that they attempt. So that's where that withdraw can come into play. Anytime you fail or withdraw a course, you're not completing, and so that can drag down that completion rate for our students. Now, let's say as a junior, we have a rough time and we end up below a 2.0 or this 67% completion rate. That would put the student on an academic warning with the college. Now, that's exactly what that sounds like. It's just a warning. It's a chance for us to like talk to the student, make sure they know what they need to do to get that GPA or completion rate up. A lot of times with concurrent, we advise that they don't take any more college classes at that point, because if they have another bad year, two rough years under that 2.0 or the 67% completion rate, they could end up on academic suspension, and that is the absolute last thing that we want to happen. We do not want to see our high school seniors graduating, but then also on academic suspension at the same time, because that is their permanent college transcript, and that can affect financial aid and their acceptance at different institutions. So I don't say this to scare you. I just want to be very clear that there are some of these policies that we expect our concurrent enrollment students to meet. So, okay, so let's say that all sounds good. You're like, yes, I want to do this. How do you do this? Can anybody take these classes? And the answer is no. You do need to do a couple things for eligibility. The first thing is students need to qualify for the program. How we determine if you qualify is by looking at your GPA, class rank, or a national test score. Also with Heights, we have a program or an agreement with your AVID or college readiness courses that if you complete those, that would make you eligible for the program. Just really briefly, juniors, we lowered our GPA this year for eligibility. So juniors need to have a 2.6 or be in the top third of their class. Seniors is also 2.6, but top half of their class. So once we know if they're eligible for the program, then we need to make sure that they're meeting their course prerequisites, which is the second thing that we look at. Pre-COVID, we came out and did an ACCUPLACER or a placement score, and that is how we saw if we thought students were placing into the courses. Due to COVID-19, we are not able to give that ACCUPLACER. So for this year, and we know for sure for 21-22, though we are not offering that ACCUPLACER, we're going to use the GPA to place students as well. Your deans, we should have all that information, but really what we want you to do is talk to your dean, talk to your teacher, see if this is a good fit for you, see if you would even qualify, and really talk about, are you ready to start that, you know, post-secondary college transcript? Just some other things to note that if you have an IEP or 504, you can request to use those accommodations for the Anoka-Ramsey courses, but you do need to go through a different process. We can't just automatically put those accommodations in place. You need to work with our Office for Students with Disabilities, and she's great. Her name is Molly Tast. She works with you to make sure that we're getting the appropriate accommodations for your college level course. I talked briefly about transfer already. The classes that we're offering in our concurrent enrollment program are really some of our safest, most transferable courses. They fall within our like lower level general education curriculum, which is also called the Minnesota Transfer Curriculum. And students at Heights have lots of awesome opportunities. Not only do they have the Anoka-Ramsey classes, but they also have the option to do AP courses and earn college credit that way. So between AP and Anoka-Ramsey courses, it is possible to get close to finishing that whole Minnesota transfer curriculum or getting close to that Associate of Arts or two-year degree. And really, regardless of how many classes a student takes, you're able to transfer them with you to the college or university that you decide. It's not an all or nothing type of thing, whether it's one class or all the classes that we offer, you can transfer them anywhere. Some other options is, or other good thing to know about is Transferology. It's a really great free resource that, it's a nationwide resource that schools put in their transfer data information. And so you can keep track of your college courses that you've, or college credit that you have earned, and see where it could potentially transfer, not just in the state of Minnesota, but all over the country. And then just a little Min State plug, Minnesota State has some transfer pathways. So if you decide to start at one of the Minnesota State community colleges, we have lots of great pathways where if you finish a two-year degree with us, it is guaranteed to go in its entirety to one of the Min State universities. So I also just want to do a little plug for my, this is where I want to talk about my role a little more. So as I said, my role is to help support the concurrent enrollment students. So part of my job is to help with that transfer piece. We really want to make sure if students are earning this credit in high school that they understand the credit that they're earning and they know where it's going to transfer, and really help in the decision-making process of colleges. Use it to your full advantage. So that's part of my role, is to help meet with students and families and make sure we're making the most out of the credit that you're earning. I just also wanted to note that if you take these classes, you are, again, an Anoka-Ramsey student, and so you have access to all of our Anoka-Ramsey resources as well, and that's another reason I'm kind of that liaison between all the resources that are available and the high school. So this is just a screenshot of our website. Currently, right now, I am working virtually, as most of us are, but I am able to meet with students and parents all the time if you have questions too. So that was pretty quick. I've got my contact information up there. Mr. Miller, do you think you wanna, anything I missed or things you wanna add?
Yeah, I'm gonna add a couple things, Kelsey, before we open it up for questions. First, for registration, just because we are distance learning right now, registration is going to look a little different. It's going to be online. So I will post the application, students, on your Highlander Google page. Okay, so I'll post that tonight after the meetings. So it's going to be electronic. And I combined it, ARCC and AP, in the same application. Okay, so that is different. So that application will be, sorry, there's more people that are trying to come in. That it'll be available tonight after the meetings, okay? The due date on that is, I'm going to give you 2 weeks from today, so it's December 16th. So it gives you 2 weeks to talk to your teachers, talk to your parents, figure out what classes you really want to take at the college level. So at Anoka or ARCC concurrent enrollment, and then after this meeting, we're going to talk about AP courses available to you. So you'll have 2 weeks to figure that out and to register for those classes. One important piece I want to talk about quickly before I open it up for questions is some students, Kelsey talked about coming into a class, oh, it's really hard, I can't do it, 2 weeks into it, and they think they can drop it like it's a mainstream regular class. We don't, with AP and with ARCC, with ARCC in particular, you do get that incomplete or that W, and that will be on your college transcript, so that's never good. But we do staffing here at the high school with registration numbers. So if you decide you're not gonna take a class, your deadline is June 1st, 2021. So it's the end of this school year to contact your dean to say, I want out. It is not September 1st, saying, Mr. Miller or Ms. Gillis, I don't wanna take this class. We're not gonna pull you out because we do staffing, we hire staff to teach classes, and because it's hard, we can't take you out. We're not going to take you out. We're going to encourage you. We're going to support you the whole way. But that deadline, and it is on the application, you will have to check it that you understand, is going to be June 1st, 2021. Okay? And please, take advantage of this. Having a partnership with Anoka-Ramsey Community College is amazing. It's great for our kids. We have Kelsey in support with it, or with the programming here. It is ultimately free with hard work, okay? It is a college-level course. You will have to work hard. It is not going to be easy. Don't expect it to be a high school class. There will be deadlines, and if you don't meet them, there will be consequences, just like any other college course. If you don't meet deadlines, it will affect you academically, but take advantage of it. On the application, we do advise students. There are juniors on this call right now, and you might be in a couple ARCC or ARCC NAP. Don't overload yourself and take 4 ARCC and 2 AP classes. Okay, that's a full-time plus college level schedule, and we don't advise that. So sophomores on the call right now, we advise maybe 1 or 2 classes, maybe 3 at max. For your junior year, get a little taste of that college level class, because again, we want to set you up for success, and we do, you know, it is on your high school transcript and on your college transcript, like Kelsey talked about. And getting C's on your college transcript is not, you will pass the class, but it's not great. And it is very hard to increase that GPA when you're starting below a 3.0 your junior year of high school. Okay? So I will open it up for questions. I can't see everybody, so you can unmute yourself and ask Kelsey or I anything top of mind right now.
If a student took the pre-calculus as a sophomore, would they be able to still take the ARCC one for the college credit?
Yes. So that would be almost a prereq to get into ARCC. I'm not going to say the only prerequisite, but we encourage students to take that high school level pre-calc before they take the college pre-calc.
Thank you.
Can you describe the the 504 IEC slide again. That didn't quite make sense to me.
Sure, I can. So if your student uses a 504 is on an IEP, we don't automatically use the accommodations for the college level course that they are using for the other high school courses. They need to work with our Office for Students with Disabilities. So our coordinator's name is Molly Tast. So she would set up a meeting with you and the student to look at what's currently on the IEP or 504 and see what is appropriate for the college level class. Because they're not always the same once we get to college level.
Okay, what is IEP and 504? What does that stand for?
So an IEP and IEP is Individualized Education Plan. I think I'm saying that right. That's like a more of a special education. And then 504 is something similar. It's for academic accommodations. So if you don't know, then you probably don't have to worry about it.
Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm. Did you say that the credits we earn transfer to basically every college that like we want or university we want to transfer to?
So we are, as I said, students come to us with the intent to transfer. So we have lots of transfer partners and transfer plans and things that we know will transfer already. It is always up to the receiving institution to say what they will accept and what they won't accept. In general, we are a public state institution. Our credits tend to transfer well to other public and state institutions, not just in the state of Minnesota, but all over the country. Private schools is where it gets a little more finicky because it's up to them. They get to make that choice. But as I said, if you have an idea of where you're going or where you want to go, that's a really good time to work with me and make sure the classes that you're taking will transfer there. Cause I have some of that transferology data I can look up too. So if you ever have questions, you can always just send me an email. I can help you out.
Okay. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. I'm assuming that the primary institutions that students are transferring to is the Minnesota State and the University of Minnesota.
I mean, students that are coming to an Anoka-Ramsey campus, yes, that's a lot of where they want to go is the U of M and other Minn State schools. But as our concurrent program, we have 15 partner high schools, and we know that students are going all over the country, and we have seen our credits transfer many places. So,
and a follow-up is that, you know, transfer students sometimes have a difficult time transitioning to the pace and expectations of a four-year institution. So what type of assistance or guidance is available for students who transfer to a four-year institution, either support from Anoka-Ramsey to prepare students for that transition, or like support that is coordinated at the four-year institution?
I can't speak to any four-year institution's plan, like support. Everyone's a little different. I know that with Anoka-Ramsey, I mean, we just really encourage our students to be working with their advisor, to be trying to be that independent learner, to be asking for help when they need it, to be using the resources.
Too late.
There's so many events and things on campus that we offer for those students, but I can't speak to transition to what specific four-year universities do. They have their own transfer advisors and things in place.
Thank you.
We had a question about the slide that you had up with the classes listed. Were those examples of classes that are currently happening this year, or are those the classes that are being offered for next year?
Currently offered this year.
Yes, and more likely, depending on registration, again, we run courses, even mainstream courses at the high school, specifically on registration numbers. So, for example, if only 5 students register for ARCC pre-calc, we're not going to run that class. So does that make sense? So we will we'll offer everything that we're offering this year. But if we don't have the numbers to financially cover that class and to make sense within the master schedule, then we wouldn't run it. Does that make sense?
Yep.
And when we take the ARCC classes, that doesn't necessarily mean we have to go to the Anoka-Ramsey College, right?
Not at all, no.
Are these classes just open to juniors and seniors?
Yes, I believe at Heights you guys just do juniors and seniors, correct?
Yes, yeah. Correct. Now AP World History will be available for sophomores.
And students who don't want to do the concurrent ARCC at the high school would still be allowed to enroll for PSEO directly to ARCC?
Yes, if they qualify.
Okay, so as of right now, I'm looking more towards PSEO, but do I still sign up for the ARCC courses at the high school if I plan on doing PSEO?
Yes,
Mr. Miller,
so
can I jump in on that one?
Oh, sure. Go ahead.
Hi, everybody. I'm Ms. Gillis, and I'm the 12th grade dean here. And yeah, when you're registering, you do not know if you'll be accepted into PSEO. And so you are going to register as if you are going to be a full-time student at Columbia Heights. And then if you go through the process of PSEO, which we'll have info sessions on that and the process of applying for that later, that'll happen more January time. Then if you get accepted and do that, then we'll take care of your registration piece after that. But you should register as if you are going to be a full-time student at Columbia Heights High School so that you make sure you get the classes, because you don't know, something might change. You might not get into PSEO. You might not get into the PSEO program you want. They might, I mean, there's lots of different things that are not guarantees. So you want to set yourself in a position where you have the classes you're going to want to take if you are at Columbia Heights High School.
All right, thank you.
Mr. Miller, can I share some information as well too?
Absolutely.
So the students that are considering PSEO, what I would say if you are going to be a junior is I think ARCC would be a great transition for PSEO. I would say try out ARCC and AP classes as a junior. And then if you feel like you're ready to be full-time in the building at a college, then do PSEO senior year or consider doing PSEO senior year. What's great about ARCC and AP classes at the building is it actually helps you transition into a college student. And there are more teachers at the high school and with ARCC that can support you with that college transition.
What's the difference between an AP and ARCC class?
Well, so with Anoka-Ramsey classes, you are enrolling in the class, you're going through all the coursework, and assuming you get a C or higher and you pass the class, you earn the college credit. With AP coursework, you go through the class, and at the end, there is an exam that you need to pass. You need to get a certain score on, and then you are awarded college credit through AP.
So would it be recommended to send an email to your dean that would say if you're interested in doing PSEO, that the dean is aware of your intent to do PSEO, although you're filling out the registration for the concurrent courses and AP classes? Would that be the recommendation?
You can email your dean, but we will send out information to everybody about our PSEO meetings. And then there will be required meetings to attend if you plan to apply for PSEO full time. So you can put it on the radar if you want, but we're going to have all students register for classes next year, no matter what. And then again, late January, early February, we're going to have PSEO meetings for parents and students.
Okay, thanks.
Well, Mr. Miller, so I have like a quick question for the registration, especially with the classes. Like if you want to know what classes the ARCC is offering and stuff, how soon is the registration going to get be open?
Great question, Godwin. Good to hear from you. Registration is going to open tonight. So you're going to, well, not officially, the application is going to be available for you tonight. And it's a Google form. So you could sign up for classes this evening if you want and submit the application. It's not due until December 16th. And then on December 17th, we're going to go through all the applicants and then preload your classes on your schedule for next year. So students that sign up for college level classes, I'm going to work with my back office team and I'm going to put that right on your schedule right away. And then lock that class in before you get to register for any other classes for next year.
Okay, thank you. And then another thing, the form, is it going to get sent by email or is it going to be posted on the Highlander page?
Great question. It will be posted on the Highlander page for everybody.
Okay.
When are we going to be registering for like all our classes?
Juniors are going to start the registration process right before winter break. Sophomores, right after winter break into January. So roughly the same time as usual.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
More information will come about registration here coming in your next class meeting too.
Okay, I have another question. So say you are applying for PSEO to the U of M. They do not actually give their admission decisions, their website says, until June 26th. If Heights is having a June deadline for being able to withdraw from ARCC courses, how is that going to be worked around?
Yeah, obviously, or if you do get accepted into the U of M, you're going to be going post-secondary. So we're going to pull you from the classes. You're not going to be enrolled in both campuses. Does that make sense? So you're going to have to go through our registration for PSEO at the high school campus. And then after you get through that, then you can be applying to any university that you choose. And then if you do get accepted into PSEO, then you'll be communicating with our deans and figuring out that schedule and classes that you're going to be taking at that university.
What was it? Did you say that June 1st was the last day to withdraw from signing up for ARCC though?
Yeah, June 1st is for students that sign up tonight or in the next 2 weeks and then maybe analyze their schedule and think, wow, this is going to be really tough. I think I might drop it at one or two classes. You need to do that before June 1st because we staff classes on numbers. Right. Now students that go to the U of M for PSEO, that's a handful. And we understand that situation, their deadlines there and getting accepted maybe late at the end of June. We'll be working individually with those families.
Okay, thanks.
And again, you'll be attending the required PSEO meetings, which is documenting that you are doing what you're supposed to be able to then, if it's after June 1st, be able to say, I'm taking these classes PSEO rather than
the Anoka-Ramsey ones.
Okay.
Wait, what if you want to take PSEO classes, but then unable to stay in Avid, you have to take an ARCC class or an AP class? So what would you say about that?
Well, if you take PSEO classes, those are considered high-performance classes. So that would be similar to taking an ARCC or an AP class. And that, again, you would be working individually with your dean on that. But a PSEO class is going to be considered the same rigor as an AP and an ARCC class.
Okay. You said we have 2 weeks to sign up for an ARCC class?
Yes. So that application will go out tonight on your Highlander page. And you have until the end of day, which is midnight on December 16th, to submit your application.
And Kelsey, how can I contact you if I have further questions?
Yes, thank you. Anybody, if you have questions after this, feel free to contact me. You can email me. Here, I'll quickly put that back up on the screen, but it's just kelsey.johnston@anokaramsey.edu. You can also find my information on the Anoka-Ramsey website. So feel free to email, call. There's also a link if you wanted to do a Zoom or virtual appointment as well. So yeah, I'm happy to answer any questions after this too. So via email or appointment.
I have a question on the Anoka-Ramsey English courses.
Yeah,
do those
yeah.
courses meet Columbia Heights English requirements for high school graduation?
I'm going to give that to our Heights.
Yeah, I assume it's Mr. Miller or one of the.
Well, I can jump in on that. The ones that are the ARCC college writing, that one does meet it. The ARCC short stories is an elective.
Thank you, Ms. Gillis.
Mm-hmm. So I'll leave this just slide up here for a second if anyone wants to write down my email or phone number too.
I can't remember if you guys said this before, but for next year, will they have to fill out, or will they have to go to a teacher to get a recommendation?
Yeah, so that changed a little bit just because you're not seeing your teachers in person. On the application, I have a question that says, please provide a teacher that would recommend you for this class. And then you're going to write in that teacher. And then after I analyze everybody that applies, I'll be double checking with teachers. So you're not getting that teacher signature, but you will be writing in a teacher's name for me that would recommend you for the class. And if you don't have a teacher, you're going to have to start communicating with your teachers tomorrow to see if you can write one of their names down for a class.
Okay, thank you.
Hey, Mr. Miller.
Yes.
So, you know, last year there was a group of sophomores who were trying to take the ARCC short writing or college writing or whatever class, and they weren't able to. They had to take AP Lit, and then we're told that they were going to be able to take the college writing class their senior year. Is that still going to happen?
Hold on. It sounds like Drake.
Yeah.
So Drake, you want to take the college writing class next year, ARCC. Yep. Is that your question?
Yeah, no, because we weren't able to take it this year. I was trying to take it this year, but they told us we had to take AP Lit. So we're going to be able to take the college writing class next year, right?
Yes, please sign up for it. It will be available. That class always... Historically, it fills up, so you'll have the chance to take it. And if we have to run, depending on numbers, more sections, we'll tackle that as it comes. But yes, please sign up for it.
All right, thank you.
So for the English courses, there's two, and I'm pretty sure one of them is only an elective credit. Which one is that?
It's going to be short stories. Is going to be an elective.
And that doesn't count for senior English, right?
No, it doesn't.
So for sophomores that want to take ARCC classes, would this mean that they would have to register next year, or can they do it this year?
So it would be next year for sophomores. So if you're a ninth grader, you're going to register for ARCC next year. If you're currently a 10th grader right now, you're able to register for classes, ARC classes, for your junior year. We're talking about next school year registration. So you'll be a junior next year.
Okay, thank you.
If I were to pass the class, would that credit count towards my high school and college then? Okay.
Yes.
I have a question. Is it possible for the Anoka-Ramsey campus to transfer credits overseas? Because I have a few universities in mind that are located abroad that suits my future goals.
We can send credits overseas. Usually if you're transferring credits overseas, there's an extra party involved. They're called WES. I'm blanking on what that stands for right now. But we have an international advisor on our campus, and so that's someone I would connect you with.
Mrs. Kelsick,
mm-hmm.
What is your contact information, your email? I would like to talk to you later.
Yep, it's Kelsey. Kelsey dot Johnson, Johnson, at anokaramsey.edu. Should be up on the screen.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Yes, no problem.
All right, it sounds like we are done with the questions right now. If you have a question or you think of something tonight or tomorrow, you can contact your dean, you can contact me, my information's on the screen too, or you can contact Kelsey. We'd be glad to answer those for you. I will share again the application tonight on your son or daughter's Highlander page. And you can take a peek at the application. Obviously, you don't have to do it tonight, but it is due in 2 weeks, December 16th, by end of day. And I did simplify the application, so it's easier to fill out than previous years. Okay, so I'll post that tonight. Thank you all for coming. We appreciate your time. Thank you, Kelsey, for your time tonight and giving us resources with our concurrent enrollment with Anoka-Ramsey Community College.
Yes, thank you for having me. Happy to do it.